you eat those ones at school? Yeah, that's great. It's great. So you're schooled me, Akifahari.
Yeah? Nah. Your head is from the camera.
Is it playful?
Yeah.
It is best end of breath and I think that is a prayer for us, but what things we haven't prayed. So you pray again. When they do that kind of salad, for carrots, because they are like slice them into big dices, how are they soft or they're hard?
This one,
crunchy,
they're really nice, right? You know, these kind of vegetables they help you manage your, you know, your body parameters, about sugar.
But you know, you have kutoka hiyo time umefanya sijui what job whatever, you're just too conscious. You're too conscious. Kwani what were the results? What was your result? Tell me, because you never told me. This are no salt.
What? I was advised that,
don't tell me the advice first. What was the result? Before any doctor can advise you anything, they must have seen the result, you know, so that they can advise you based on what they have seen or based on the outcome that has come.
So what do you want?
How was your result?
Good. The figures were not bad. However, without monitoring. Without monitoring what you're consuming, it can easily jump over to the levels on your other side. So, there is, you know, like the way you have
alkaline.
So,
give it.
Alkalinity. Those are things that have higher pH. That is above 7.0. To make it more interesting, you can look at it. When you have water, water is at 7 pH. It's neutral. It's neither alkaline nor acid.
You used to have alkaline. Alkaline, the other word you've said is?
Alkalinity and acidity.
Na base.
You don't even get that. So, with that, when you have like it's here, that is hydrochloric acid.
What is that? It?
That is an acid, so it has a pH lower than 7.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right? Yeah, 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 yeah.
So, if you want any solubles on water, depending on what solubles you have put, the pH, yeah, the pH can either go to towards the alkalinity or acidity.
Mm-hmm.
Very fun. On the same note, we have, when you're measuring your BP, that is the blood pressure, and your heart rate, right? The neutral or the recommended, blood pressure and heartbeat is 120 milliliter per pressure, 120 over 70. That is what is recommended.
So yours was above that or below that?
So when yours is below, there is a problem.
It's too high.
Okay, there is a range between 120 to 120 over 70 to 140 over 80. 140 over 90. So when you pass 140 over 90 upwards, you are hypertensive, you have high pressure. Okay, your heart is beating very, very fast. And you know what brings about, you know, your heart beating so fast? It's because, you know, your veins, your arteries, the areas with which the blood flow to, it's called the arteries. I mean, barbara dam. It's either an artery or a vein. Do you remember? There used to be pulmonary artery, aortas, pulmonary veins. So pulmonary artery nini inatoa damu kutoka kwa heart. So if those veins are blocked, what can make it be blocked? One, you may have some fats that are blocking your veins. So that's why when people grow fat, you find that their heart is beating very fast. Well, because they need to push the blood through a clogged pores, arteries and veins, right?
So that's why it's so much not good to be fat.
You're not good? You're not good?
That's not fine.
It's not good? And that's why you find somebody there,
but they are. Most.
So you find that they are very conscious, because you know this information is very easily available for patients in India. But as in Kenya, beforehand we didn't know what was killing our people. What was killing our people and it still is, is this body issues. One, blood pressure. Two, blood sugar. Three, hypertension. And then which is because the moment you become high pressure, or sukari yako in the blood has gone very high, in affect much, in affect your system, you understand? So by so doing, you find that your parameters start going higher or lower depending on which side of the boundary you are. That's how. So mine came as 130 over 80. And you see, danger zone is 140. You know, even danger because people are walking with 200 plus. But recommended, come aside, she's 120. Okay. If you can try to maintain that for the rest of your life, and that's why it's very important to monitor your parameters, because you'll be able to know when your body needs some exercises, when you need your heart needs a lot of water, a lot of vegetables. You'll be able to know. You feel me?
Yeah.
So with that kind of a parameter, it means you need to be conscious of what you're eating. Stop a lot of stop kabisa because inafanya kazi ya heart yani kwa nguvu sana.
Kula.
No.
So talk to them. Talk to our viewers. What they tell them what you. What can you tell them based on the information you've given us? Because I know that's here to watch us eat. You know, like this was just a glimpse of part of them, our glimpse of part of us. You know, so it has happened. We have had a we are having a conversation. So you can just like based on what you've learned, you've gone through, like that experience, the current experience. So what can you tell them? And in terms of weight, you know, just sometimes squeezy, especially right now, Napata. Hey, says you cannot talk. You cannot talk about weight. You cannot talk about anyone's weight. In as much as maybe you want to tell that person in a good way, or you keep them in one or the other. Francois, everyone, you guilt to say sorry. You're body shaming me. You're body shaming us. Naja, that is the me. Is the trending thing that is happening right now, you know, and it's not the thing because it might happen that you want to tell someone whether your weight is like this, you can do this and this, you know, but once you just mention anyone's weight or how you're supposed to eat because you want to enlighten them on something that maybe you've learned, wanna get it by. So, how can you put it out there?
But you see, it doesn't go without saying that fat people don't have good, you know, pressure. Heartbeat doesn't go without hitting it. It just means that when the fat has accumulated to the extent it is affecting the system, the pH of your blood, that's when it becomes a problem.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's why you find doctors advising or health practitioners, they always advise you, please don't eat and sleep in the day. Especially when
take your dinner early, 5-7.
Yeah, take your dinner early, like 3 hours before you sleep. So that the food can be able to be absorbed into the system. If you don't do so, what is going to happen is that when you take your food, of course there are going to be some compartments there. There are going to be some proteins, maybe some vegetables, right? So the worst thing is the issue of the carbohydrates, you know, like garden chair. Isn't of it was in a single one. So what happens is that when you eat that and you sleep immediately, you know, carbohydrates are energy-giving foods.
Yeah.
So when you're hibernating or you're sleeping, your body do not need that energy. Are you following me?
Yeah.
The body doesn't need that energy. So what happens is converted to blood sugar. So you find that your levels of sugar in your blood is going high. So that's what leads to diabetes.
Well, a lot of people are very diabetic.
Because of that. So if our advice, if you're listening to if you're taking your supper, please make sure that before you take your supper, ensure that you have a good time frame. And ensure you have at least 2 hours in between you going to sleep and eating. Okay? Another thing I would want to advise you. From a point of experience, rather, is that, you know, whatever meal you're taking, I wish I could be able to show you how you're supposed to take your portions. Like tonight, what is your in other words, balanced diet.
Mm-hmm.
What is recommended that you eat? All right, your plate, I'm assuming, is like ours, which is sad. Maybe the others will have you can always have a center. If it's a square, look for the center. Where is the center? Okay. If you have your wife there, she's the one serving you, show her, this is the center of my plate. Alright?
Mm-hmm.
So when you have the center of your plate, this side, one half, it should be veggies. Alright? I'm talking about sukuma wiki, cabbage.
The way yours was.
Yes. Easy, which is hizi vitu zinaitangwa mboga za kienyeji. Ensure that half of your plate has veggies, right? Then you're remaining with the other half. So the other half you need to subdivide it into two halves. So that means you'll have a quarter and a quarter. Okay. If you're going to sleep or any other time, you have a quarter and a quarter. So what you do, ensure that you have a carbohydrate, because your body needs carbohydrates because they are energy giving food, and you know during the day there's a lot of activities. So you're running up and there, and that is what gives you the energy to carry on with your business for the day. So make sure that when you have at the center of your plate, you have one half having vegetables, then the other half you need to divide it into two quarters. Are you together? Yeah. Are you following me?
Yeah.
So two equal quarters. So one quarter should have carbohydrates. I'm talking about ugali. I'm talking about mchele. Maybe chapati here and there. Okay, maybe mashed potatoes. Those are the carbohydrates I'm talking about. That's what you always eat. Unajua wa Kenya tumezoea lazima ugali hang kwa sahani. This is a especially hao watu wa kutoka na huku
Bungoma
County. Lazima ugali hang kwa sahani. Okay, that is bad eating habits. Okay?
And
this is what is killing our people silently. You find that somebody is in the hospital, number one problem she has or he has is that he has a high blood pressure.
What has caused
that? I'll give you, we're going to have a question and answer session. Whereby you're going to ask your questions, whatever you have, and I'm going to answer.
Mm-hmm.
Is that acceptable?
Okay.
So, ugali isi hang kwa sahani. Okay? Utasikia just kwa kwanza, lakini if you maintain those portions, you're going to get used to it. So one half, one quarter half carbohydrates. The other quarter, you're going to have those things that are called proteins. Each meal, it's recommended that you have a protein. Each meal, in your plate, every time you're eating, have protein, have carbohydrates, have vitamins and veggies, right? That's how. So, the other portion, tutakuwa na nyama. Watu wengine lazima nyama ijae kwa sahani hapa na ugali kwa hapa. Hapana. Okay? So, the way you do it is that in your plate like this one, gawanisha. Kama leo nimevunja record. You normally don't eat like this. This is a bad eating habit. Okay? Especially like right now we're going to sleep. You're not supposed to take this kind of thing, but nevertheless, we are here. Okay, we're going to take a lot of antioxidants. I'm talking about water, green tea, and everything, so that you can be able to remove all those oxides in our body. So, have your plate divided as that, and you're going to thank me. 50, 60 years later, you'll be breathing like a small child, right? Otherwise, stay tuned. Thank you very much. I think at that point, we're going to have a segment whereby you're going to ask your questions and I'm going to answer them. Any questions, class?
That will help. It could 25 minutes. It's not too long. It's 25 minutes. Because I got that. Upload, but anyway. Guys, you're going to have questions. Just ask your questions and we will deal with them in the next video. Okay, so thank you so much for joining us tonight, for joining us in Dining with the Martins. Thank you so much. God bless you. This was just a glimpse of what happens in our house, so we just decided to give you a taste of it. This is just 1%, right? It's just a percentage of it. And at the end of it, I always tell you guys, no video, no vlog, no content I'll ever upload that is not inspiring in one way or the other, or is not educative. So, as you can see, we were dining. Yes, we have just arrived from a bit late because we are coming from outside. So, we are planning to have this dinner in the car as you are coming, but we just decided, let's come home and have a proper dinner, and then we sleep. But you see, something has come up and we had to have this discussion based on what we eat and how we can live healthy. And so as you have heard, if you have any question concerning the diet, kindly ask us. Waluya wenzangu huko nje tafadhali, ile ambayo wanasema wale waingo ati tunashika ugali namna hii alafu tena kasubuka na tushana katoko hivi. Please, let's stop. It's not possible. Tuache mchezo tunafanya, acha niwaambie mnachaza ukali namna hii imechaa alafu nakunywa supu iko hapa. Nyama iko hapa ni mfupa mmoja. Hii nyingine yote ni ukali unapatiza peke yako. Yes. Let's stop it. It's not healthy. It's not healthy. Let's grow up. Sawa sawa. Leo? And then pia kwenye wado wa nyumba tafadhali. Imekataa kutoka. Mnakula waru sana na zupu. Mnapika nyama, mnapika zupu. You overcook the meat until all the proteins that are supposed, every nutrients that you're supposed to get from the meat inaisha. You understand? So that means we have a lot to learn, okay? So any other question by the next video? My husband and I are gonna tackle it, and we are going to learn so much on how to live healthy and sound. Because remember, your body is the only thing, or is the only permit that gives you to be in this world. So if you can take care of your body, take care of your body, okay? And let's mind what you are eating. Do you have any words to round up? In 1 second.
Just to say, a very big thank you for your continued support. Indeed, it has been, we're making tremendous progress. You can look at the subscribers, and now we are approaching 2,000.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for your big support.
Thank you.
And I wish that every content that is being uploaded in this channel is helping you in one way or the other, alright? Whenever you have a question, go ahead and ask your question. We're going to handle your questions every other time that we're having a common discussion. Otherwise, cheers, the word works.
The word works. Just comment down below whatever question that you have. I'm currently out of Instagram, but just comment down below and let me know what you think, and we will answer you. But next video, we are gonna talk about health and how to stay healthy. Sawa sawa. Just remember, no matter what you go through, we don't give up, we don't give in, we don't back out. Until next time, it's your girl Tatiana the Brown. Cheers, and you have a wonderful evening, wonderful afternoon, and wonderful morning from whichever part of the world that you're watching me from. Auf Wiedersehen, bis morgen.